In Flensburg mussten meine Schüler zum ersten Mal zeigen, dass sie das sehr schwierige Sacre du Printemps von Stravinsky meistern konnten. Und das ist, wie jeder weiß, einer der härtesten Nüsse zu knacken. Aber sie machten mich stolz. Sie waren einfach wunderbar. Das Orchester war hervorragend. Ich glaube, jeder gab sein Ganzes für Stravinsky.
Die jungen Orchestermitglieder waren natürlich unendlich dankbar, dass Lenny Zeit fand, ausgerechnet nach Schleswig-Holstein, nach Salzau zu kommen, wo sich doch die ganze Welt um ihn reißt. Ausgerechnet in Salzau, in einer Scheune, dort arbeitete und probte er mit ihm.
Well, here we are. Hi, guys. You know what I want to do? I want to play some scales. All right? Slow, fast, major, minor. See, we've never touched each other, so let's do that. Everybody starting on the lowest, let's say C, of his instrument, and going up two octaves and coming down again, right? Nice and slow, C major. Find your lowest sounding C, not very brave, very brave. We want to go up two octaves and back. Don't repeat the high note. Just come back, all right? That's good. Wonderful. Sensational orchestra. One of these days, I want to try, instead of scales, improvisations. Now, The Rite of Spring by Stravinsky is all about sex and reproduction. And the smells from out there, it's very good. But this, because it all means the same thing. It's growth. And we start from one little high C. Where are you? Who's the unlucky man? You. All right.
The Rite of Spring is a famous piece for being difficult. And one of the most difficult things about it is the beginning, which opens with a solo bassoon who has to play in a very uncomfortably high register of the bassoon, which sounds like anything but a bassoon.
Coraggio. We all love you, so that's the first thing.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Why do you take so much time? I know I said I was going to follow you, but so viel Atmen zwischen. Are you German speaking? Yeah. Okay. So lange Pausen für das Atmen. La di da di para. Es ist ein continuous melody. Ideal, it should be without Atmen. Aber ohne Atmen kann man nicht.
Und dieser Mensch ist total unbegleitet. Er ist ganz allein, wie ein Stierkämpfer, bevor er in die Arena tritt. Ganz allein und in den Händen der Götter.
Wonderful. This is going to be sensational.
Stravinsky's Rite of Spring seems to me to be the ideal kids piece at the moment. And by kids, I mean talented kids, of course, and I don't mean four-year-olds. But this piece, which used to be considered practically unplayable back in 1913 and through the 20s and into the 30s, has become a repertoire piece.
Man hat selten die Möglichkeit, mit solchen Dirigenten in unserem Alter, ich bin noch nicht mal Student, mal wirklich zusammenzuspielen. Das ist einfach was anderes. Normalerweise hat man wirklich seine Taktkratzer da vorne und nicht irgendwie Leute, die wirklich Musik machen. Das ist schon was Höheres. So, ne? Das ist einfach die Erfahrung. So, man muss das auch lernen. Ne?
The whole ball, every time. The whole bow means from the frog to the point on every one. These are, I don't know, dinosaurs or whatever you want to picture, but it's that kind of heavy. Well, here, bow is very good, but you have to diminish afterwards. 49. Tutti. A bass drum, you should have the softest, biggest mallet. You have a mayoche, you know, they call it. Oh, so it'll go with the basses and make one big dinosaur out of all of you, okay? Oh. Piccolo, piccolo clarinetto. Play me this trill entrance. We must hear this trill. It's as important as the melody. Faster, faster trill. It's a lazy trill. Why do we? That's good. Fun.
Qu'est-ce que je ramène chez moi comme souvenir?
Was ich als Erinnerung mit nach Hause nehme. Das ist schwierig. Ich weiß noch nicht. Es ist ja noch nicht zu Ende.
Grazioso. Ja. I think you're all too well-mannered. You've been brought up too well. Trop bien éduqué. The big downbeat in the tutti has to last the full quarter. Ah, really bestial. I mean, this is beastly music brought to the highest, most refined point. So that means tubas. Until the second beat. Do it. That's right. You play ball. We need this. It's primeval, primordial, whatever you want to call it. The glissando, all notes as long as possible, right? Then let me hear the glissando. No good. It doesn't make me sick. I want to feel sick. In other words, the glissando must be as slow as possible. You know, it's a slow tempo. You realize how long it takes to get from to all that. Go. Getting there. One more time. That's pretty good.
Jeder von ihm halt so diesen wahnsinnig, eigentlich erotischen Tanz praktisch dann auch auf dem Podest macht. Ne? Das ist einfach schon interessant zuzugucken, wie er das da halt so versucht rüberzubringen zum Orchester und andererseits eben halt, wie man eben halt auch merkt, dass das Orchester praktisch reagiert.
All right, let's do 53. It's not just loud, and it's not just long, although it is both of those, but it's also deep, heavy. I mean, these are big, prehistoric memories of Russia, or of the animal kingdom, whatever you want to call it, whether it's a rhinoceros or a buffalo, or just the feeling that one has in the spring sometimes of wanting to be immersed in the earth itself. You know, you've all been through that. These dances are all performed by adolescents, so I guess a lot of you should know what I'm talking about. But think of that. Think of the times. I'm not just wasting words. All the times that we all experience in adolescence that I remember like yesterday, when you're lying on the ground and it's spring or summer, and you lie down face down on the ground and you want to kiss it. You watch the grass grow. You listen to the grass grow and You want it just to enfold you. You've all had that experience. Where you're lying near a tree trunk and you want to take it in your arms. That's what that dog means, is, okay? Too much talk.
I almost began to cry when he talked about everyone during
Ich musste weinen, als er über das erwachende Leben im Frühjahr sprach. Das auf dem Boden liegen und die Bäume und die Erde umarmen wollen. Das berührte mich, denn ich fühlte genauso und er drückte es aus.
It touched me because I felt it and he expressed it so much.
Boy, that was sensational. You should hear what you're doing. I wish you could all come up here and hear it. In love with the earth. That's what you just did. 4 before 59, everybody. See what happens to the music if you run, if you rush, even the least little bit. What happens is it becomes weak. It's impotent. This is all about potency, okay? It would be good if you could do all down bows, but it's much too fast for that. Try the unprovable, prove the unprovable. Try the unmentionable, all right. Let's hear 3 before 61, strings only. All down bows. Ha! One! I knew you could do it. I knew it all the time. In fact, that's the way I have it in my score privately. But I want you to discover that that's what you need to hold to make the piece work. Okay. Very good, second oboe and all that stuff.
Der ist irgendwie für mich so wie ein Zauber oder so. Wenn der da vorne steht, dann muss man so spielen, wie der dirigiert.
Four before 59. Damn, I'm wasting too much. I'm not wasting, but I mean, this goes so fast. Last entrance was too late by one beat, and I don't feel this prehistoric jazz. It's a kind of elephantine jazz, very Russian, very. I don't feel the jazz, man. Bop, 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 tutu. It runs. See the way these strings play eighth notes? Everyone is the same. You have to be able to do that.
Nein.
Appeals very much to young people. The rhythms, the unequal rhythms, the asymmetrical rhythms, the rhythms that have been copied in jazz and in rock music, in fact.
Now let me hear that with the, let's hear 67, horns, violas, coming in 68, and oboes. 67 now. Everybody's just fine. Now, timpani, bass drum, you still keep your three-quarter beat. Now, tam-tam at 68. Let me hear your lovely duet with the bass drum, without timpani. Bass drum and tam-tam. Three, four. You have a lovely waltz over all this. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, it's not at all, it's boah. Great. You got it, don't waste it. Two bars before 70. And then let's see what happens to you at 70. I didn't say anything about Agüero. I just wanted to see what happens to those three people. Otherwise, we'll never figure it out, right? Two before. See what's happening. They go right on doing what they were doing in four time, only they're now fitting it into. This is a great African combination, by the way, of rhythms. Everybody's imitated. Nobody quite so wonderfully as this. Way back in 1913, I want you to know.
Das Stück ist einfach mit Bernstein einfach super, weil er hängt sich da voll rein und es macht einfach Spaß, da mitzuspielen, auch wenn man nicht so viel zu tun hat.
Was ich empfinde, kann man in keiner Sprache der Welt ausdrücken.
With any language that I know.
Now let's do it up to tempo. From one bar before 72. That gorgeous chord that came from nowhere. I can't hear it if you talk. We're playing. One bar before 72. Is that all you're going to give us, bass drum? We have to get excited. Vomit number three. There's a lot of it in this piece, right? Oh, that's so beautiful. Never hear this part that without remembering my kid brother's story when he heard me do this at Tanglewood. He was 13 or something. I was a kid, student. And we came to this point, the end of part one, in the silence, some lady in, among these 5,000, 6,000 people out there was saying, "I always use lard." I cannot come to that point without hearing that. Let's have lunch or something. Please.
Right. Yeah.
Where's the guy? The viola player. Anyway, tell him he's right.
In dem Moment, wenn die Orchestermitglieder losgelassen werden, sozusagen, wenn sie nicht mehr festgekettet sind an dem Platz, an dem sie die Bratsche spielen, finden sie meist Gründe, zu mehr nach vorne zum Pult zu kommen. Ihre Gründe sind sehr interessant und manchmal sehr lustig. Viele kommen mit tiefgründigen Fragen, warum zum Beispiel das A im Bass in einer anderen Fassung der Symphonie ein H ist. Und was meinen Sie dazu, Maestro? So einer gibt nur an. Eine andere kommt vielleicht und fragt, spielen die Violas da nicht B, während wir H spielen? Bei dem ist schon ein bisschen mehr dahinter, denn er hat etwas mit seinen Ohren gehört. Wieder ein anderer kommt vor und will ein Autogramm.
You've lost your original, Madge. I could have signed it for you and you'd be a rich man after I die.
Yeah.
Which may be tomorrow.
Dann kommen sehr oft Leute zu mir und fragen, könnte ich 2 Minuten mit Ihnen haben oder 5 Minuten? Und ich sage, schieß los, die ersten 15 Sekunden sind schon vorbei. Fang an. Und dann kommt, eigentlich kann ich jetzt nicht, denn in Wirklichkeit meinen Sie nicht 2 Minuten, denn in Wirklichkeit meinen Sie auch nicht 5 Minuten. Sie haben schwere Probleme, ganz gleich welcher Art, die Sie gern mit mir bereden würden.
Ask you about a problem that I have in music making that maybe you could help me with. When I play, I get so
involved.
That's the problem. I am not involved.
I would not.
Meine Reaktion darauf hängt sehr stark davon ab, wer das ist, wie lange ich den Jungen oder das Mädchen schon kenne, wie viel Zeit ich habe, bevor ich weg muss, wie viel ich glaube, helfen zu können. A little more than just a joint.
Yeah, well, I figured that it's something obviously within me that's stopping me from doing this, because I've experienced that ecstasy in music making.
Now is night time. At 79 begins part two. And, you know, in the ballet, the original ballet, in this night, a virgin is chosen. The élu, the elect one, the chosen one, and they glorify her. She has to be the youngest and prettiest in this village, and she then dances herself to death in the final dance, sacral. And our problem is to remain alive during that dance. And her soul goes up to heaven, but we can stay here and look at our notes. So, there are two things happening at the beginning. One is a D minor chord. Oboes and horns play this chord, just so you know, you can judge your intonation, because everything else is not D minor, right? That's fa, a little more, that a baby, great. Now, everybody else play the first note that you have. Just hold it as a chord. I'll play the second one. Now, we alternate between those two. We are in eighths, of course, it's in sixths. But all that against the horn chord, so that's everybody. Ah, wonderful. Yeah. Oboes, you have to be very soft, softer than you're being. I know it's ridiculously high oboe writing, but there's a lot that's ridiculous, it's very special. That's why the piece is so distinguished. Let me hear the alto flute and you together. From the point of view of intonation, as well as connecting these long notes. That's pretty good. You took a breath after the first bar? I didn't hear that one. I wish you could take that breath. Because what's starting is the next two bars of the tune. They just repeat, it starts the same way as the first bar. So take that breath and no other, all right? Okay, 85, everybody. Keep that legato. Flautando. Right, I'm sorry, we have a little work to do here. Just a little wood shedding. Flautando. The whole bow, even if you ricochet. You know what I mean? Ho, ho, ho. Right, first downbeat is a rest. One. Perfect. Let me hear this horn entry. Basel. There were several voices lacking. Do it again, and don't make the diminuendo until you played the second note, then diminish on the hold. Now, yeah, right. Now, play the next one, which is a bar before 102. Just jump for the moment. Two trumpets, bar before 102, and horns. Same idea. Do we then disappear, right? That's great. That's when, did you all see Fantasia? Is that how you all first heard this piece? Now, this generation doesn't know Fantasia very well. We were brought up on it. It's been re-released, I know, but kids don't run to it the way we used to. Anyway, this moment was unforgettable in Fantasia. There are all these mammoth animals grazing and chewing their cud peacefully. And they look. And there's nothing. So they go back. And they chew and they chew. And then the paru, that second one. Body, body, and up. Couple of dinosaurs and it's all over. It's a fantastic moment for me of remembering my youth, so forgive me if I indulge myself a little.
There are orchestras that respond very well to interdisciplinary teaching, and there are those that don't. Said, okay, maestro, you want it louder or softer? Faster or slower? Come on, just give us the news.
Three before 101. Oboes, you weren't quite with us with the celli. There's a big distance. You have to depend on ZI a little more. Okay? It's too fast. It's not baru. It's in tempo. Baru. What? Oh. Right in this bar. One bar before 102. You now have to wake up, count rests. Right. Hey. Right. Must have looked at these notes. 103, however, is fairly lousy. And the 11 beats had no communality. I shouldn't have to beat that bar at all. I mean, once you get the downbeat, you just play it. In fact, I'm not going to beat it at all. All right? Let's make a little arrangement. Now, let's make this a celebrando one more time. That was good, but not good enough. You know what I mean. And with the accelerando is crescendo. Right? It's both. Down to pianissimo. Yeah, go on. Thank you. That's very important. Forte. You got the tune. People fell out, went overboard. All right.
Every part had attention.
Jedes Instrument ist wichtig. Er verlangt Außergewöhnliches und ist nicht zufrieden, bis er es hat. Und das ist fantastisch, denn wenn er es bekommt, dann stimmt es auch.
123 again. Good. Big diminuendo now, everybody. No, this is not staccato. Not staccato. This is like a Russian choir. No, there are words going on in my head in Russian. I don't know what they are, but. No, but everybody the same way. There's no legato. It's just do, do, di, do. So Christos was Christia. There, that's right. He's mertwich. Bom, 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 bi, bom, bi, bom. You know what I mean? Isn't that a Duke Ellington lick? That always strikes me. All right, one more time. Bassoon. Okay. Very fine.
Ich glaube, das Stück werde ich kennen, wenn wir hier fertig sind.
Great. Fantastic. Now I will answer your question. What is the secret of the T-shirt I was wearing? It's exactly about this. Last summer I was conducting the New York Philharmonic. We were going on tour, and the trombones, which is a great section, and it's a new section, they're very proud of it, were not giving what the pathétique needs of Tchaikovsky. So I said, come out, and they're enormous people. You know Warren Deck, the tuba player? Well, he's as high as, they're enormous, it's like from primeval times. And I said, is that all you can give, you hunky brutes? And so these hunky brutes, gay, boy, did they give from that day on. And we did a whole tour, came back to Philharmonic Hall, having been in Los Angeles, San Francisco, Chicago, blah, blah, blah. We came back and recorded the pathétique, and they showed up as a chorus line, you know, all the trombones and tubas with this T-shirt. And that's something. So now I can reveal the secret to you, because they made me president of this. It's one of the great honors I've ever been paid. I mean, the Nobel Prize. Who needs it? All right, now let's do the coda. Very real secco. And very piano when it's piano, because this is an extraordinary dance. It's so ecstatic that sometimes it doesn't touch the ground. That's the idea we have to get from it. Of course, that's all spring earth still. But that. Which is all, if any of you have ever played Scriabin, it's note for note, stolen, but it's gorgeous. The fifth piano sonata. But it's so wonderful. If you just play lightly these ecstatic little places, and then it has a combination of charm and horror that is, I don't know what to compare it to. Blue Velvet. Has anybody seen Blue Velvet? Something like that. All right. 186, everybody. Cuban secco. Bass trumpet. Secco, secco, secco. Until on the third beat. One, and two, and yep. See, it has to be in tempo. Okay. Last beat. Yes, and how about non crescendo, which means diminuendo, going up. Just do it in flutes. One. Flutes and piccolo. One, two. Now, come on, all of you. One, two. Pretty good. Why do you get stuck there before the end? Da-da-da-da. Something, I don't know. One, two. Come. Don't look so shy. I let me hear everybody, the last two guys. I have to work on that. Right. I cannot do this to you anymore. You are fantastic.
Ja, ich glaube schon, dass ich nervös bin. Und ich glaube, die anderen sind auch alle nervös. Ich bin wahnsinnig traurig, dass diese schöne Zeit jetzt hier vorbei ist, weil sowas habe ich noch nie erlebt. Und mit Bernstein zu arbeiten, das war einfach großartig.